Please subscribe to this channel and also tap the notification bell in order for you not to miss out on any of our videos. A meeting of utmost importance has just put secessionist leaders and Swiss representatives on the negotiating table. Inclusion is about drawing the contours of an effective way out of the crisis. It is one of the financiers of the separatist movement who is in Norway, Ayabacho Lucas, who leaked the information of these negotiations between the Swiss representatives and the leaders and other financiers of the secessionist movement, which bloodied the Northwest regions and Southwest regions on August 21st. Dr. Ayabacho confirms this on his Facebook page. At my invitation, we met the envoy appointed by Switzerland. This information, which received a favorable reception within the public opinion, comes just 5 days after the end of the presidential stay in Switzerland. According to the Swiss Federal Department of Foreign Affairs, this meeting is part of the continuity of the mediation initiated for more than 2 years already. Since Switzerland has been mandated by a majority of parties to facilitate an inclusive negotiation process, informs the Swiss authorities. The head of state, President Paul Biya, has obviously reactivated the file of the Anglophone crisis with a view to defining the contours of a return to social cohesion. Especially since for some time, Ayabacho Lucas has been very favorable to the option of negotiation with the power of Yaoundé through concrete acts. We remember that it was he, over a year ago, who opposed his comrades in the struggle in the perpetuation of the dead cities. However, Switzerland, we know, plays a role of mediator and facilitator in the Anglophone crisis in order to promote peace negotiations between the government and the separatist groups. Since the start of this mission, she has benefited from the support of the Center of Humanitarian Dialogue, an organization based in Geneva, and whose reputation is established in the field of mediation. So far, in addition to the meeting last Saturday, several others of this kind have already been held between the separatist leaders and the Cameroonian government, in particular that of May last year or even June 25th to 27th, 2020, we learn from this file. This is news which gladdens the entire international community, which welcomes the acceptance of concessions by the protagonists. We therefore welcome this initiative which traces the furrows of peace in the English-speaking regions of the country. A swan song fueled by commitment of the parties to get actively involved in the resolution of this conflict, we hear here and there among those who have faith in this mediation.